There are four integer types we can use, depending on how large a number we need a variable to hold. Many C++ compilers also support the long data type, which is guaranteed to be at least 64 bits. To determine the exact size of a data type, we can use the Sizeof operator. This operator returns the number of bytes a data type occupies in the system we are compiling for. The Microsoft C++ compiler also features sized integer types. These types starts with two underscores, followed by int, and then the number of bits we want the integer to hold. By default, all the number types in Microsoft C++ are signed and may therefore contain both positive and negative values. If we know we only need to store positive values, we can declare them as unsigned to double their range. Signed and unsigned may also be used as standalone types, which is short for signed and unsigned int. The short and long data types are also abbreviated in this way. The floating point types can store real numbers with different levels of precision. They can also be assigned using the standard exponential notation. As for the precision shown here, it refers to the total number of digits in the number, so trying to assign more than 7 digits to a float means that the least significant ones will get rounded off. The character type is usually used to represent ASCII characters. The conversion between the number stored in the char and the character shown when we print it happens automatically. For another integer type to be displayed as a character, we have to explicitly cast it by placing char in parentheses before the variable. Finally, we have the Boolean type, which can only be either true or false.